Take a look and examine the legs of the model. I expect you'll see some odd shading on them. If you make the headlight brighter, the effect will become more obvious. Moving the spotlight is likely to shift these patterns around. The shadow mapping algorithm works by seeing the world from the light's point of view. The depth image formed is then checked during normal rendering. The depth of the surface visible at a point is compared with the transform depth that the shadow map buffer holds. And that's where all the trouble begins. The pixels in the light's image of the world don't exactly match up with those in the camera's view. These cause some form of what's called surface acne, where little dark dots or patches appear in areas that should be fully lit. Take this example. The light's view of the surface says that it's 3.80 meters away from the light. The camera's view of the surface says that the location is 3.81 meters away from the light. Since this value is slightly higher than the light's view, the surface is considered in shadow. The surface does something that should be impossible. It shadows itself, as the depths don't compare as well as we would like. Here's a demo showing the problem, as well as a partial solution. On these surfaces, you can see patterns of acne, where the geometry is shadowing itself. One obvious solution is to add some tolerance value, called a shadow bias. If the camera's computed distance along the light's view plus this bias is less than the light's depth, then consider the surface lit. Unfortunately, a simple bias leads to another problem, called Peter Panning. Just like Peter Pan, the object starts to look as if it's become detached from its shadow and sometimes as if it's hovering above its true location. In the 35 or so years this algorithm has been around, many different solutions have been proposed to this problem. There are other problems with shadow mapping, such as the edges of the shadows looking pixelated, and solutions such as percentage closer filtering and cascaded shadow maps. I won't explain these here except to say that 3JS has both of these solutions built in.